Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 6th March, on the front page you have no bank guarantees meant a more expensive new Rafale deal. So this is Indian negotiating team's final report, which revealed how Indian negotiating position was weakened and the French position strengthened by parallel negotiation track. So this is the exclusive report of the Hindu on the Rafale deal, how the Indian team got a bad end of the deal in this case. And here you have tariff hike to hit exports to US. So US President Donald Trump has notified US Congress on ending GSP benefits, that is generalized system of preferences benefits, which we have discussed quite often, under which India, being a developing country, gets preferences for, you know, a lower tariff for export to US. So Trump has notified US Congress to end GSP benefits to India. He says that Indian trade barriers are the reason that we don't want to provide India with these trade benefits. Already we know that India has a huge trade surplus with USA. So US is in trade deficit. So these are the measures which are being taken by USA. Then below you have Masood Azhar's brother's son held in Pakistan. So Pakistan government has cracked down on terror outfits. 44 members of banned organizations have been taken into preventive detention. And also Masood Azhar's brother, that is, this is, we saw how Lashkar-e-Taiba's offshoots, Jamaat-ul-Dawah and Fatah-e-Insaniyat Foundation were put on the proscribed list a day earlier. And now the founder Masood Azhar's, Jaish-e-Mohammed founder's brother and son have been held in Pakistan. Then on page 7 we have 15 of the 20 most polluted cities in the world are in India. So there are two cities from Pakistan and one from China, one from Bangladesh. So these are the 20 most polluted cities in the world. It is topped by Gurgaon, that is former Gurgaon. Here you can see Gurgaon in Haryana topped the list with average annual particulate matter PM2.5 quality of 135 micrograms per cubic meter. So this is the data for 2018. So that's the highest here, 135.8. Then here you have Assam gets smart fence along border. So a digital barrier has finally filled a 61 kilometer gap on the 4096.7 kilometer India-Bangladesh border fence. So 3 decades after the project was kick-started, now Assam has got, in Assam region, this digital barrier has been put in place. So Assam shares 263 kilometer border with Bangladesh, and much of this border was fenced, but a 61 kilometer stretch in Dhubri district remained open due to terrain dictated by the Brahmaputra river. So now a digital barrier has been put in place here. Then below you have Supreme Court seeks center's response on immigrants. The Supreme Court has now sought response from the central government on fresh petitions which have been filed seeking to quash a series of subordinate laws which allow naturalization of illegal migrants who are Hindus, Sikhs, Buddhists, Jains, Parsis and Christians fleeing religious persecution from Bangladesh, Pakistan and Afghanistan. So you can see this provision is similar to the provision under the Citizenship Amendment Bill, which we have been discussing for so long. The bill, we know, has lapsed after it was not passed by the Rajya Sabha, though Lok Sabha passed it. So the bill has lapsed, but the central government has brought in the effect of those provisions already through subordinate legislation. So it has actually inserted these provisions under the orders and rules. So here now a petition has been filed in the Supreme Court challenging these provisions. Below you have Supreme Court asks petitioners to clarify stand on green crackers. So we know the Supreme Court had asked that in India only green crackers should be manufactured from now on, but we had seen how there were no manufacturing of green crackers taking place and the Supreme Court questioned the authorities on this. There is this Petroleum and Explosive Safety Organization, PESO, who has to look into this matter. So it sought more time. So Supreme Court is now asking petitioners to clarify their stand on the matter. So green crackers would result in lesser pollution. So they are being formulated. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Life Without GSP. So this is regarding generalized system of preferences, which we discussed on the front page, which US has stopped. The benefits under it have been stopped by USA for India. So it says India must not underestimate the impact of the US withdrawal of trade privileges. So that aspect is discussed here. The second editorial, Algeria for a change. So Algeria in Africa, here President Bouteflika, it says, should withdraw his re-election bid. So this is regarding internal politics of Algeria. And the lead article is Recovering from the Hanoi Setback. So this is regarding the collapse of talks between US President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un in Hanoi in Vietnam. So this article says, whatever the reasons for the collapse of US North Korea talks, both sides have kept alive hopes for their revival. And the article below is 50 years apart, the story of two OIC fiascos. So this is regarding Organization of Islamic Cooperation. So India for the first time was invited at OIC as a guest, and Foreign Affairs Minister, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj gave a speech here. So it says, this article says that reaching out to the OIC is morally wrong and politically futile. Then on the op-ed page, you have an interview here. So this is an interview with Foreign Secretary Shyam Sarin. So he talks on how Pakistan should be isolated diplomatically, on world's response to Pulwama attack, and even New Delhi's Kashmir policy. Then on page 11, you have the continuation of front page news regarding no bank guarantees meant a more expensive new Rafael deal. So this is the detailed coverage here. Then this is pension scheme for workers launched. So this is Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan. So this is a Yojana for pension scheme to be provided for workers and laborers of the unorganized sector. So this was announced in the interim budget in February 2019. So it will provide a monthly pension of 3,000 to employees in the unorganized sector after 60 years of age. On international page, you have China targets 6 to 6.5% growth in 2019. So this estimate is lower than 2018 estimate of 6.5% growth. Also, defense spending, it says, will rise 7.5%. On business page, you have India downplays impact of US GSP withdrawal. So this is regarding generalized system of preference. So we have seen on the front page that US has announced withdrawal of GSP. So India says that this is not going to hit exports much now. So center is keen to continue talks as it still has 60 days before the rules take effect. Then there's no other important news, no news coverage on the last page too. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com in the current affairs section. Here, the current affairs is uploaded on a daily basis. So, you can view the current affairs here as a PDF too. Everyday news is available here, plus also monthly compilations are made available. Also, there is a detailed current affairs video uploaded on a daily basis too, but that is a separate course. You can enroll for that. The details are provided here. And sample videos are also available. So that is it. Thank you.